£5 for this concealer and it covers tattoos. That's going right in my bag skit. It is the one. Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, we are going to be doing a what's in my makeup bag tag. Now I know we're not going anywhere, so I'm not taking my makeup bag anywhere because I'm in the house. I'm not using it at the moment. But if I was to take my makeup bag somewhere, this little makeup bag, it's got Tinkerbell on and it says don't let anyone dull your sparkle. How cute is that? I would be having this stuff inside it. This is the stuff that I'm loving at the moment. So let's start with my beauty blender. My favourite beauty blender is just the Real Techniques beauty blender. I've not actually tried like a real beauty blender. Like, is there a difference? Should I try a real beauty blender? Let me know. But this is the sponge that I'm loving at the moment. I would take it everywhere with me. If I could take anything anywhere, that would be nice. Next thing in my makeup bag is the Makeup Revolution Translucent Setting Powder. Talc free, no flashback, water resistant. Oh, it's got that packaging where it has all fingerprints on it. No, not coming off. No, still not. This is a really good setting powder. I'm loving this at the moment. It's massive. Like, you get, it doesn't say how much you get in it, but it's big. You get a lot, like compared to other setting powders. I can't see any right now to compare, but compared to other ones, this is really big. And I think it was like £5. It is translucent, like obviously all translucent powder, it looks white in the tub. But when you use it, and I press it into my face with a beauty blender, and that's what I've used today, and you can't see it, and I can confirm that there is no flashback with this powder. So this is absolutely brill. This is my new makeup bag staple for every day. Next thing we're fishing out of my giant makeup bag is another powder that I've been loving at the moment. This is the MAC Studio Fix Powder in NC25. Technically, this is a powder foundation, but I use it to set my face. It controls my oils, it makes it so I'm not oily throughout the day. It's absolutely brill. And because it's a powder foundation, it adds a bit of coverage as well, which is really good for the areas that you need it, like when you're setting and stuff. It covers everything. Fit a lot in this makeup bag, you know. There's a lot of stuff in here. The next thing, let me just make it a bit cleaner, because it's just not pretty unless it's clean. This is the Fenty Beauty How Many Carats Diamond Balm. This feels absolutely insane. Like, I can't even describe the texture of this. But it's like, it's so soft, and then it's just like full on glitter. Like, let me try and get a good focus on this. It is absolutely beautiful. It's brill if you want glitter over the top of eyeshadow. So you could do your whole eyeshadow look, put your finger in this and just dab it on your eye, and it is, yeah. What I've been loving on my lips at the moment. First lipstick that I am loving at the moment in my makeup bag is this one from MAC. It's from the Love Me collection. So the new really hydrating lipsticks, they've got argan oil in, so they're really nice on the lips. Look at the packaging. The packaging of that lipstick is everything. I think MAC lipsticks, oh my god. Smells like, this one smells like chocolate. It smells so nice. That's going right in my bag skit. Who is she? I've got this on today, and as you can see, you probably can't see because you've probably been blinded by this highlight. You probably know what I'm gonna say because I use it in nearly every video, because my absolute favorite highlight in the whole entire world, Benefit Cookie Highlight. Oh my gosh, it is my favorite highlight in the entire world ever. Like, and just nothing compares. Like, look at this. It's just unreal. Like, this highlight is the one. Like, it is the one. My favorite concealer in the whole world, which I also talk about in every single video and can't rave about it enough, because this concealer is amazing. It can cover absolutely everything. Like, I tried it on my tattoo on my ankle the other day to see if it would cover it, and it did. Like, it's a £5 concealer. £5 for this concealer, and it covers tattoos. It covers everything. let me just tell you what it's called, because I've just raved about it. It's the e.l.f. Cosmetics 16 Hour Camo Concealer. Looks like this, because there's another one, and that one is not the one, but this one is. The other one, not so good. This one, it's like a dupe for Tarte Shape Tape. Like, and it is just amazing. It's £5. It's £5. You can get it in Superdrug, Boots, whatever. It is amazing. Next, a lip glossy type of thing that I've been loving. I like a, it's a lip gloss, but it doesn't feel like a lip gloss on the lips. Like, it's not really sticky, and I think that's why I'm really liking it at the moment, because I'm not about sticky lip glosses. Like, I just can't deal with my hair getting stuck in it. I can't deal with the feeling of it on my lips. Like, I can't be chilling at home with lip gloss on, because it just does not feel nice. Like, I'm not chilling if I've got lip gloss on. So this is the Makeup Revolution Precious Stones Lip Topper in Ice Diamond. So it comes and it's like completely silver, but as you can see now, it's kind of got like a pinky nude tinge to it, because I'm an idiot and I just go ahead and just put it on top of my lipstick and put the dippy thing back in here, and it just changes the colour. But when it comes, it's like a clear silver with like sparkly reflex in, and that is so nice. It feels so nice on the lips. And coming from someone who can't wear lip gloss usually because it's just too uncomfortable, I can wear this. Thing that I've been obsessed with at the moment and would be in my makeup bag every day, because it is so easy to use, it is so quick, and it can change your whole entire look up. Like, I recommend this to everyone. It is the MAC Liquid Dazzle Shadow in Not Afraid to Sparkle. It's so pretty. It's like a liquid eyeshadow, but it's just full glitter, so I'll show you. So on the back of my hand, full on glitter. Like, look at that. I love them. I love any like liquid shadow at the moment. Like, I've got a Stila one that my mum got me for my birthday, and that is my absolute favourite, but it's run out now, and that was my favourite liquid shadow ever. Like, I use that every single day. The Stila ones are 10 out of 10 as well, so I would recommend them as well. But they look like this, and they are beautiful. I love them. Bad Girl Bang Mascara. I'm loving this at the moment. I feel like it just really does make my lashes bang. You know, it makes them so much longer. It's really black, which I love. Like, I don't like a mascara that, like, I don't know, some of them go on and you just can't really tell the difference between the colour of your lashes, and it doesn't really change it, but this really does. I've been using this for like a year now. Like, it's one of them ones that I just keep using and using and using, and it's great. I love that. Let's move on to foundation, because I haven't really spoke about foundation, and obviously I wear foundation every single day, and it would be in my makeup bag. So my favourite drugstore foundation, my cheaper foundation, getting the baby out, L'Oreal True Match. Like, I rave about this all the time, but if you're looking for a cheap foundation that has really good coverage that lasts all day, L'Oreal True Match is absolutely brilliant for that. Like, it's £10, you just can't go wrong with it. It's great. Like, if I'm not wearing like my MAC foundation or my Estee Lauder foundation or my more higher end foundation, I will be wearing this, and you probably can't tell the difference. Like, that's how good it is. My other fave, which I don't have a bottle of because I've run out, I've got a little sample, is my MAC Pro Longwear Foundation in NC15. That is what I'm wearing today, and I feel like it just makes my skin look amazing. Like, it looks not real. I look airbrushed with this foundation on, and it lasts forever. Like, I could probably, I think it's like claimed to like last like 36 hours or something, which no one would ever wear makeup for that long anyway, because you'll have no skin left when you take it off, so I don't recommend trying that. But it probably would last that long. Like, it's one of them foundations where if I knew a zombie apocalypse was gonna start, I wanted my makeup to look good throughout the whole apocalypse, I would put that foundation on to last the whole time, and it probably would. Favourite blush, MAC Blush Baby Blush, and I absolutely love this blush. I've got it on today, I wear it most days, I feel like it matches my hair. If we were outside and my makeup bag was full of makeup, that is what would be inside of it. Hope you enjoyed seeing what was in my makeup bag. I better put it all back in my drawers. Not in the makeup bag, but that is what would be inside of it. If you like videos like this and you like to see the types of things that I use on the daily and the stuff that I'm loving at the moment, then don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe down below and turn on the notification bell so you are notified when I post a new video, which is becoming a daily thing at the moment while we're all in this crazy time that we're in. But we'll see. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.